beings. Their purpose is to help. We ask, to help whom? Because we are in a level to ask like that. I want to help my wife because I have a body. Wife and husband are relationships of the bodies, not to the persons living. I want to help my children because the false relationship of son and father, which is quite different from the relationship of God and man, which is the only relationship between son and God. The physical father and physical son is a false relationship. God and man is the true relationship between father and son. But we have mock relationships by the physical body. Imitation, fake relationships. So we want to help our children. For the same reason we want to help our friends. We want to help the people of our own religion, our own subsect of our own religion. If I happen to be a Roman Catholic, I don't prefer to help a Protestant, I want to help only a Catholic. If I am an Indian, I prefer to help only an Indian, not a Swiss. These are the relationships of the body necessitated relationships. Therefore, when we are in the stage of the physical body, when we are not the masters of our mind, we are sure to put the question, to help whom? Then they have no question, because they have no necessity of the physical body. To help means to help those who need. Wherever they find a need, they begin to help them. And how can we know that they have helped? Maybe our question. But their question is, what is it we get when you know that we have helped you? Why it is necessary that it is Mr. So-and-so who has helped? We do not understand that question. Because when we help somebody, we want him to understand that we have helped him. We are more important than the helper. But to them, help is the only importance, because there is no personality. There is only light. This is the next step of evolution. And from this stage onwards, they begin to group into two different groups. One who work from their heart center, a second group who work from their head center. They have neither heart nor head in the physical sense, because they have no physical body. But they have the heart and head as center. Even while we are in the physical body, it is not the physical heart that is our heart, but the physical heart is only a seat of our heart. Just as our brain is only a seat of our mind. Can you say that the brain cells in your brain can be called mind? Just as your brain is not your mind, but only a seat of your mind. Just as your brain is the seat of your mind, so also your physical heart is the seat of your heart. This is the case even when we are having the physical body. So, the head and the heart mean the head center of consciousness and the heart center of consciousness. So the supermen divide themselves into two groups, the head group and the heart group. The head group go on helping mankind in one direction. The heart group of workers go on helping mankind in some other direction. The detail of how these two groups help is a different subject in itself, which can be clearly known by the volumes of Alice A. Bailey. But it is enough for us to know now that we begin to help the beings in the mineral kingdom also by making them, by making their evolution easy. We will help the four kingdoms simultaneously, the mineral kingdom, the plant kingdom, the animal kingdom, and the human kingdom. And thus, we begin to make the planetary work of this earth. Then we understand that the earth is a living being, and it is not a globe like the non-living globe in the geography class. So we understand our part in this earth. and we begin to work along with the intelligences of this earth. That means the devas that are working in the mineral kingdom of the earth, the water, the fire and the air. We begin to cooperate and we begin to work with them. So before the biological evolution, it is the deva kingdom that works. After the human kingdom, it is the deva kingdom into which the Superman goes and works along with the devas. In the meanwhile, the physical human being has a behavior which is to be adopted so that his evolution may be hastened into perfection. That is, by playing an important part in the symbiosis of the four kingdoms of the earth, you should be able to make the earth fertile, make the earth fertile by using the animals to serve the, to till the earth. And you should be able to feed the animal with the fruit of the earth, and then you should take something from the animal without killing the animal. For example, the milk, the yogurt, the butter, and then you should help the Deva kingdom also. Your presence should help the earth, the plant and the animal. When you make the animal work in the field and when you make the earth work for the animal and yourself, when you learn to eat after the animal eats, and then after the plant is given its own food, if you lead such a life, which is the only method of life of symbiosis, that is, when you are able to stand one with all the living beings, making a channel between, that is, a channel from plant to animal, a channel from animal to yourself, a channel from yourself to the plant. If you maintain this triangle, then your evolution on this earth will be hastened. Is hastened, stimulated, made quick, made swift, speedy, accelerated, made accelerated. And as a result, you will touch the sense of perfection. And the question touches your mind, who am I? You will respond by practicing the yoga way of living. And reaching the samadhi state, you will reach perfection and the need of the physical body is finished. Then you begin to work in the Deva kingdom directly. This is the duty of the human being as far as his obligations towards the Deva kingdom are concerned. This is a very intricate subject and a very vast subject which requires at least 1 week of teaching and not lectures. But I have tried my best to make the purview of the subject clear so that it may stimulate interest in you, so that you may grow aware of the new science that is being developed, the science of the Deva kingdom, which is the only alternative that makes you peaceful even though you are a scientist. The advancement of science should not make man a beast. Otherwise, man makes a mass suicide in the name of global war. And we cannot boast that we are not beasts because we know the world situation at present. It is only by the consequences that we can know whether we are beastly or human or superhuman. So, by becoming aware, by becoming aware of the Deva kingdom, we can know what cooperation is and how to do supplementary work with others, and then the development of science will be quickened and the danger of the foolishness of man towards science will be removed. So this can only stimulate your mind towards the new science. It is a great event that a new movement is humbly started in Geneva with as few as 9 heads and hearts in the name of International Planetary
Synthesis.
It may be very small in the beginning, like the seed of a banyan tree. The seed is the smallest, but the tree is the largest in the banyan tree. So I contribute my lot of work and my everything to the work of the planetary synthesis. And this attempt to speak about the Deva Kingdom is my first attempt to you, so that you may begin to work with your Devas. Thank you all. No, that's the attempt to accelerate us, our evolution to superhuman living. It is not vegetarianism, because milk and milk products and animal products are permitted. Because Pythagoras gave the solution. He said, it is not important whether it is a plant or an animal, but the desire to kill and eat should go. That is what Pythagoras said. It belongs to your place. You are living in the nearby the same place where it is started. It gives you better opportunity than me to know it. Because my physical state is only 1 week. First question, let us answer. Only when we have submitted our instruments of learning to the training given by the masters, we will be able to understand and what is. When our instruments have the zero error of personal emotion, when it is the instrument has the error of personal emotion, for ourselves decide with our instruments of mind and thought what is good. So until then, the works of the masters are standard to us. That means the world scriptures are the standards to know what is good and what is. That is the first question. And now let us know what is the second question. I'll try to answer it. Memory is one layer of mind, and intelligence is another layer, discrimination is another layer, creative thought is another layer. Like that, we have thousands of layers in the mental plane. Intelligence is a quite different layer from memory. Memory is repetition, whereas intelligence is something known for the first time. They are on the plane of recollection, on the plane of intelligence, on the plane of the states of matter, construction of this earth planet, and on the plane of the construction of the tissues of the body and the energy centers in the body. And the solar system is also being constructed by the Deva Kingdom. What we call the properties of matter is only the evidence of the existence of the Devas in the form of matter. So every layer is made up of the Deva units. In one plane they work as intelligences, in another plane they work as recollections, in a third plane they work as groupings, in which group the cells into the various organs. Division of the cells into the different organs. So all the functions that are beyond the capacity of our knowledge, whether within ourselves or outside, are being conducted by the groups of the Devas. That is what it is. No, we have to know still
more facts by reading the original books where these Deva kingdoms are described. In the Secret Doctrine and in the volumes of Alice B. Bailey, we have to read and understand the things, and then only we can have an idea of this. It is not correct that intelligence is the activity of the Devas, because thought matter is worked out by Devas. Mind substance is constructed by the Devas, and thought forms are conditioning us. That itself proves that we are not independent in our thought. We can think according to our likes and dislikes, and therefore we are not independent. We are puppets of our likes and dislikes.
Yes, I understand. But you have to understand your position amidst these millions and millions of Devas at first. The relationship between your existence and the Devas in your constitution. Then only you will be able to understand that your likes and dislikes are only like the direction of the drift of your ship. Suppose you are sailing in a ship. Suppose you are the main pilot of the ship, and there is a gale, a storm. One ship escapes the storm and comes out safe. Another ship ends in the disaster, drown. It is a tragedy. One has arrived safe and the other is disaster. Is it the storm that is responsible? Something more. That is the one who is driving. That is your position. And the storm is not for the sake of the ship that has taken place, but the storm is the consequence of a bigger truth, which is the activity of the whole ocean. And your relationship with the storm decides the result. That is how the Devas work with us. They can work neither good nor bad with us. They can discharge their own duties on the path of evolution. And it is our relationship with them that makes the tragedy or the comedy of our life. And the likes and dislikes are the impulsions started from us, not from the Devas. And the Devas execute these impulsions. Whatever you give them, they will execute. Suppose there is a big wind in a gale, big wind in a storm. If you put your hand out from a hole in the door with a current, small currency, the currency goes away. If you hold 100 francs, it goes away. If you hold 1,000 francs, it goes away. If you hold only a little paper, it goes away. If you do not hold anything, nothing goes. On what factor the value of the loss is decided? It is not the behavior of the wind that decides the number of francs you lose.